2021, what a year for guns. Glocks making carbines, Berettas making revolvers, and now Smith & Wesson is making pump shotguns. No, not something like the 9/16 from 50 years ago, but something like 50 years from now. This is the Smith & Wesson M&P 12. It's a two-tube bullpup 12-gauge pump like the Kel-Tec KSG or the Utosh UTS-15. And why people aren't calling this genre of guns bullpumps is beyond human comprehension. Really, it's mind-boggling. Many of you may recall that I visited Smith & Wesson for Gunfest this past February, and let's say I saw some shit when I was there. Some new things that are going to happen that I can't tell you about in the absence of a court order. This was one of those new things. Over 6 months ago, I saw carts full of these shotguns being pushed off the S&W assembly line, so this has been a long time coming. Whether you like the idea of a bullpump or not, these days Smith & Wesson is revisiting its college years, becoming more adventurous, open-minded, and probably willing to try Molly. That may have been a joke, but I have to re-emphasize how excited I am to see S&W pivot more towards what consumers are interested in rather than what it thinks consumers should be interested in. The Shield Plus and the brand new M&P 15 T2 are great examples of this, and the best is yet to be announced. Let's talk specs before we get into the review of the shotgun, which came out today. The M&P 12 is, again, a 12-gauge bullpup shotgun that has two tubes, each holding 7 rounds of 2 3/4-inch shells or 6 rounds of 3-inch shells plus one in the chamber for a total capacity of 15 rounds. Obviously, you can glean from that statement that the M&P 12 is capable of accepting either. It will also work perfectly with mini shells and will hold a whopping 20 minis. Because it's configured as a bullpup with a chamber more or less in the buttstock, it has a 19-inch barrel but an overall length of 27.8 inches, exactly 10 inches shorter than my beloved Beretta 1301, and it is downward ejecting. Now, there is a weight penalty for this extra tube, as this shotgun weighs 8.3 pounds, or 2 pounds more than a Mossberg Maverick. It's 1.4 pounds heavier than the Kel-Tec KSG, but it's built like a rock using a steel receiver and black oxide-coated 4140 steel barrel. Ooh, and that business end sure is intimidating and threaded for rim choke compatible chokes and accessories. The steel construction likely accounts for the additional weight of the M&P 12. The weight's also not that noticeable considering that the center of gravity is closer to the shooter's shoulder, so even one-handed aiming and shooting is possible with this thing, even though I wouldn't recommend it. The M&P 12 has an Ambi AR-15 style safety that's going to be extremely familiar to AR shooters out there, as is the grip. While the MP12 comes with an M&P style grip with interchangeable back straps, just like you saw with the M&P 15 T2 that just came out, it means that if you don't like it, you can just swap it out for a standard AR-15 grip of your choice, and that's pretty cool. This cross-bolt style push-button tube selector is intuitive to use and it's fast. If you need to switch tubes because the tube you're firing from went dry or even cooler, if you have one type of ammo in this tube and another type in that tube and you need to swap between the two, just flick this button, you're good to go. It also has these fin-looking load assist buttons on either side of the back end of the receiver, kind of where the buttstock meets the barrel shroud. A light press on these fins makes shells easier to load, while a hard press will dump all of them out, making the gun easy to unload. But you have to be careful when you're tactically reloading or administratively reloading so as not to press these buttons too hard unless you have a fresh shell already on the way into the tube or it'll spit everything out. It also has an access cover that allows you to get to and to remove damaged or stuck shells without completely disassembling the shotgun. You also will know that there's one in the chamber because right here you have a tactile loaded chamber indicator. It has an Ambi QD push button sling mount point at the base of the buttstock on either side. There's plenty of space for lights and optics as the barrel shroud has several M-LOK points on both sides of the gun. And there's a good foot of rail along the top of this gun. The M&P 12 comes optics ready, which means no sights or optics at all, But these days, I'd rather just save the money on the MSRP, pick up my own optic, pick up my own iron sights or whatever, other than being forced to buy something that I'm just going to remove, and that's okay. Speaking of MSRP, this one's going to be $1,165 MSRP. I picked up this M&P 12 yesterday afternoon, and I got 100 rounds of mixed 12 gauge, brought it all to the St. Bernard Indoor Shooting Center to give the gun a try, and Sam and Kelsey of St. Bernard gave me a hand. We started out with 6 and 8 shot, regular 6 and 8 bird shot, and eventually moved up to 2 3/4 inch and 3 inch upland bird and some buckshot. Shooting a pump reminds you of why shooting a semi is a little bit more fun, and recoil mitigation is one of those things. That said, the M&P 12 handled everything from bird to buck as well as any other pump would. That isn't to say that it was pleasant or soft, which is not the case at all. It's just to say the recoil is pretty much like any other pump 12 gauge, if not a little softer due to the additional weight. We had no failures whatsoever, and manipulation with this gun while firing is top notch. Kelsey, who is of course smaller than Sam or I, handled the M&P 12 well enough, even with high brass, when she leaned into it and widened her stance a little bit. The pump's easy to manipulate, and it ejects spent shells forcefully. You have to be careful with short-stroking the pump. Again, it's not something that's easier or harder to do with the average pump shotgun. I'm just reminding you to get a full, lengthy stroke on the pump to make sure the next round chambers. For some reason, I had no problem with that. Speaking of pumping, the M&P 12 comes with an M&P style foregrip that's attached to an M-LOK slot on the foregrip. You can remove the foregrip if you want, and you can use a more conventional horizontal style grip. This probably looks familiar to you if you've ever shot or if you own an M&P pistol. It's that same grip serration that you see on the slide serrations of the M&P pistols, kind of a neat little touch by Smith and Wesson. You're probably going to want to go with a standard horizontal grip if you're using a light, or you can swap out to a vertical foregrip of your choice as long as it's M-LOK compatible. I thought the M&P 15 grip worked well enough, although I think it looks a lot cooler without it, but I've never liked the look of vertical foregrips on pump shotguns anyways. The trigger isn't going to blow your mind, but the same can be said of any bullpup long gun, not just this one. That said, it's really not that bad. There's a little bit of take up and then like a plasticky feeling trigger pull of about 6.5 to 7 pounds. It's average to good for a bullpup long gun. Again, the shooting controls are well thought out, from the ambi safety to the intuitive tube selector switch, and the vertical foregrip does work well for recoil control and for working the action. Reloading can be a bit tricky though, and you have to flip the shotgun upside down to do it. There's this big access port in the back, but it does get a little crowded with a hand and a shot shell in there. On top of that, the shells don't effortlessly glide into the tubes. You need to overcome the retention spring pressure. To assist with that, you can use these load assist buttons that I talked about earlier on the top side of the receiver. If you give them a little bump, once the hole starts entering the tube, the rim will pass through easily. But again, you have to be careful to not press the load assist too hard before you have pressure against the shells already in the tube. Otherwise, it's going to spit them all out on the floor. It might help to have 3 hands if you want to tactically reload the M&P 12. However, Sam, being the genius that he is, figured out an easier way to reload the shotgun quickly and without setting it down.
If you kind of put the buttstock into your chest and cock the shotgun to the side at about a 45 degree angle, you can drop that right on into that groove there. She lines right up with that that magazine. Just like that.
God, you make it look so easy.
Like any new platform, it'll take some practice and some manipulation, but in one range session, by the end of it, Sam and I went from extremely frustrated to awkwardly comfortable with reloading. You'll just have to give it time. This was the only real issue I had with the M&P 12. Oh, that and the shelf right above the grip here was kind of rubbing the base knuckle of my thumb in a weird way when I was shooting, but I was the only one who experienced this. Maybe it's fixed if I just changed a grip out. I haven't even had the M&P 12 for 24 hours as I record this video. I picked it up only minutes before we hit the range yesterday, but the M&P 12 has left a positive impression on me so far, and it seems to be the highest quality bullpup option right now. It has robust construction, well thought out controls that'll be familiar to most shooters, ample amounts of M-LOK and rail, the ability to change the grips to what you want, mount the optic that you want. While it has an MSRP, almost $300 more than the Kel-Tec KSG, you do get what you pay for. And both of these guns are good options. As with most things Kel-Tec, the KSG is more of a budget-oriented fit, finish, and construction, a bit more unpretentious, if you will. On the other hand, the M&P 12 is more of a, let's see, Paul Allen's bullpup shotgun vibe, with a sturdier feel and a sleeker appearance. Myself, personally, I favor the traditional pump shotgun layout, and personally, I do not partake of the bull pump. But there's something to be said for holding 15 rounds of 12-gauge in one gun, and it's a popular format for that reason. Some quick math tells you that if you carry the one, even if reloading takes twice as long for the M&P 12, if you only have to do it half as much, you're breaking even. If you're a bullpup shotgun enthusiast or even bullpump curious, I think the M&P 12 is one of the best options on the market if you can swing the extra $300 premium over the KSG. Well done, Smith & Wesson, and I'm looking forward to seeing what else you guys are launching over the rest of the year. Guys, thanks as usual for watching. We have to say thank you to our sponsors, Ventura Munitions and Top Gun Supply. If you want to win a free gun from Top Gun Supply, our supporters on Patreon and Subscribestar, that's patreon.com/TFBTV or subscribestar.com/TFBTV. If you're at the $5 or the $10 level, you are automatically entered every month to win one of four guns randomly selected from Top Gun Supply. Unlike many channels out there, we don't take money in exchange for positive reviews, so we rely on viewer support from viewers like you through Patreon and Subscribestar to keep us going. We also don't monetize through YouTube. We use a direct ad campaign, so if you saw an ad at the beginning of this video that looked like it was a YouTube ad, it was probably about guns, that was not an ad placed by YouTube. That was one of our direct ads. So we are not monetized through YouTube anymore. We really appreciate the support if you can help us. But as usual, we're just glad you're watching. Take care.